You've definitely seen them everywhere, from sci-fi space battles, to dramatic sunsets, and even in hype music video. Lens flare used to be something filmmakers avoided because it was considered as a technical flaw, but now they are a powerful storytelling device and design tool. Hey everyone, Max from Maxon Training Team here. And in today's video, we are diving into the world of lens flares. More specifically, how you can use Red Giant Real Lens Flare to craft beautiful cinematic lens flare in your own work, without needing to hunt down those rare vintage lenses. And in this video, we will discuss about some topics that can help us understand lens flares, their origins, evolutions, and the magic behind the optics. But before we get into it, let's talk quickly about what a lens flare actually is, and how this accidental artifact turned into one of the most iconic visual motifs in modern filmmaking. So, lens flare happens when a bright light, like the sun or a headlight, hits the lens from a specific angle and scatters. Some of that scattered light reflects off the internal lens element and the camera sensor, creating ghosting and streaks on your images. Some flares are subtle. Meanwhile, some are wild. And depending on the lens, sensor, and the lens angle relative to the light source, lens flare can look completely different. Wide-angle lenses or lenses with many elements usually flares more. And the shape of the lens flare really depends on the lens design. A lens flare from a spherical lens will look totally different from its anamorphic cousin. There are different types of flares, like ghosting or those soft color blobs all around the image. Streaks, or the colorful lines, and veiling glare, which gives you that soft rainbow haze over the image. And each of this look really influenced by the internal design of the lens, the shape of the aperture inside the lens, and the quality of the light traveling into the lens. In the early days of cinema, lens flare were unwanted and considered as a technical flaw. Directors and cinematographers went out of their way to avoid them. That's probably why, whenever we watch the great timeless classic movies like Orson Welles' Citizen Kane, we hardly seen any lens artifact like lens flare. But that changed in around 1960s when filmmakers want to showcase that their movies weren't made in a movie set. The captured lens flare turned the look of the movie to feel more like a candid documentary and established the sense of authenticity. Later on, Steven Spielberg started using lens flare as a storytelling device to evoke realism and emotional depth in his movies like The Close Encounters of the Third Kind, as well as in Indiana Jones and E.T. Then, in 2000s, J.J. Abrams took it to a whole new level. Movies like Super 8 and Star Trek showed a bold aesthetic use of lens flare to add energy and style. Eventually, lens flare becomes synonymous with stylized storytelling. And by the way, check out this excellent video from our friend at Vox, which discusses exactly about this. Lens flare used to be a mistake we always try to avoid, but today it transforms into an artistic choice. Today's lens flare are not just used for realism, but as a design element, especially in digital content where cameras don't produce them naturally. Video games replicate them for the atmospheric immersions, and for filmmakers, they signal cinematic quality. But the real secret? They must be intentional. They need to support the narrative or guide the attention, not just because they look cool. This is where plugins like Real Lens Flare comes in. Real Lens Flare is a procedural lens flare plugin that generates realistic lens flares based on the design of the real cinema lenses. Instead of capturing the lens flare on the film set with all the moving variables, Real Lens Flare allow you to direct the aesthetic looks and the intensity of your lens flare right on your clean captured or rendered image. The render engine of Real Lens Flare takes the geometry of the lens physical design, models how light passes through the glass, and simulates a lens flare based on a specified light source. This is a major evolution from how flares were previously computed as 2D primitives. By tracing ray of simulated light, Real lens flare can generate flares that move, morph, and merge as the light source shifts across the screen. Real lens flare is an exciting new step toward rendered lens flares that are quite indistinguishable from the real thing. And if you're ready to start creating your own flares, stick around for part 2, where we dive into Red Giant Real Lens Flare interface and controls. Spoiler alert, it's easier than you think. See you there.